Hello everyone, this is Nitin Mohor and today we are going to see IC555 as monostable multivibrator. Before this video, we have already seen how IC555 is used as a stable multivibrator and bistable multivibrator. And today we are moving on to the third application of IC555 as a monostable multivibrator. Monostable multivibrator, as the name suggests, mono means single. So it has got a single stable state. And it's also called one-shot multivibrator. It has only one stable state. On triggering it, it moves from stable state to quasi-stable state, and remaining there for a very short time, it returns to the stable state again. Means how it moves when triggering, when it is triggered, it moves from stable state to quasi-stable state. In quasi-stable state, it remains for a very short time and returns back to stable state. After coming back to stable state, it again requires triggering. It's a sequential logic electronic circuit that generates an output pulse. Here we are seeing the diagram of IC555 and externally connected resistor and capacitor and a trigger input, or the negative going pulse is provided at the trigger input, that is pin number 2. Output is taken at pin number 3, which is Q bar output of the RS flip flop, as it can be clear from the block diagram of IC555. On the right hand side, we are seeing the waveforms, different waveforms. The negative going pulse, that is trigger pulse, then capacitor charging action we have shown here, and the monostable output voltage which you are getting across pin number 3 that we have shown. When triggering pulse or triggering input is less than equal to VCC by 3, we are talking about the lower comparator, and we are talking about this negative going pulse. When this negative going pulse goes below the voltage less than VCC by 3, the output of lower comparator, that is comparator A2, that is also called trigger comparator, goes high, which resets the flip-flop, and therefore Q bar becomes 1. So here you can clearly see, as the triggering pulse goes below 1 by 3 VCC, the output of the monostable multivibrator goes high and Q becomes 0. Since Q bar equal to 1, Q becomes 0, which reverse biases the transistor and the capacitor starts charging. Now capacitor starts charging from this VCC through R1, and as the capacitor starts charging, the voltage at this pin number 6 goes on increasing. When the voltage at this pin goes beyond 2 by 3 VCC, the output of comparator A1, that is upper comparator, which is also called as threshold comparator, goes high, which sets the flip-flop, that is Q equal to 1, thus Q bar equal to 0. So as the capacitor starts charging and it moves toward 2 by 3 VCC, the output goes to 0, which was initially 1. Thus the transistor is forward biased. Since Q equal to 1, the transistor is forward biased, and the capacitor quickly discharges through the transistor. Now the voltage at threshold pin starts decreasing. Now see, capacitor starts discharging like this through discharge pin. So when the capacitor is discharging like this, the voltage at this point, pin number 6, goes down, which results in output of comparator A1 equal to 0. That is, upper comparator's output goes to 0. Thus the flip-flop resets, and since the flip-flop resets, thus Q bar again becomes equal to 1 and Q becomes 0. Hence the output of timer goes to high state and return to low state back. Waveforms of monostable multivibrators are as shown here. Three different signals we have shown. One is the trigger pulse we have shown here, which is negative going triggering pulse, according to which the output is going from 0 to 1. It is remaining 1 unless the capacitor is charged to the value of 2 by 3 VCC, and as it reaches 2 by 3 VCC, the output comes back to 0. From the waveforms, the initial capacitor voltage, when it was not charged at all, it was 0 volts. And the target capacitor voltage is plus VCC, because it is charging through the supply VCC. The final capacitor voltage up to which it can reach, that is 2 by 3 VCC, because at 2 by 3 VCC the output is changing. So therefore it is not going beyond 2 by 3 VCC. The target capacitor voltage is plus VCC, definitely, but the final capacitor voltage up to which the charging can take place is 2 by 3 VCC. Hence, the switching equation will be, now switching equation is a standard equation which can be written as the final capacitor voltage is equal to the target capacitor voltage into bracket 1 minus e raised to power minus t upon RC, where t is the time interval. Hence, actually 2 by 3 VCC is what? This is the final capacitor voltage, that is equal to target capacitor voltage is VCC into bracket 1 minus e raised to power minus t upon R into C, where t is the time interval. Hence, we can write the equation like this, 2 by 3 VCC is equal to VCC into bracket 1 minus e raised to power minus t upon RC, where VCC on both sides will cancel out. Therefore, you will get 2 by 3 on this side and here on this side 1 minus e raised to power minus t upon RC. If I shift this 2 by 3 to right hand side, that is 1 minus 2 by 3, and if I shift e raised to power minus t upon RC to left hand side, so I will get e raised to power minus t upon RC is equal to 1 minus 2 by 3. Now 1 minus 2 by 3 is 1 by 3, so I will get e raised to power minus t upon RC equal to 1 by 3. That is e raised to power, now minus I will remove from here. So when I remove minus e from here, so I will get e raised to power t upon RC is equal to, on the right hand side instead of 1 by 3, I will get 3. That means t upon RC, instead of e raised to power t upon RC, I am writing t upon RC will be equal to, I can write log 3 to the base e. That is t is equal to, now log 3, the value of log 3 is approximately 1.098. So I can write t is equal to 1.098 into RC, and 1.098 can be approximately written as 1.1. Therefore, t is equal to 1.1 RC seconds. This is the formula for finding the time period of the monostable multivibrator output waveform. You can calculate the frequency of the output waveform by taking the reciprocal of this, that is 1 upon t is equal to 1 upon this value, that is 1.1 RC. If you know the values of R and C, you can easily find out the time period and frequency also. I hope the idea of this IC555 as a monostable multivibrator is clear to you. Thank you.